Hello, Dons. Welcome back to another episode of Seer Vision. I'm your host, Mauricio Arroyo.
And I'm your host, Jose Marquez.
And as you can see, this is a different form, form of a podcast. We just want to test new things out. With that being said, let's get into the events that happened during February. So, Jose, did you know that Valentine's Day just happened? And as this happened, we had our choir club, you know, sell flowergrams for $3 each. Did you know about this?
Yeah, I knew about it. I saw some of them come into some of the classrooms, you know, delivering the roses and everything. And I think our crew managed to, like, you know, get a little bit of footage on it. So I think we should take a look at it.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm Mrs. Rookie. We're in the middle of our Valentine fundraiser, and you guys, our very, very loving Dons, have helped us shatter the record for the number of roses sold. We have sold over 950 roses to be delivered out on campus today. So thank you guys for sharing the love. Keep positive. We're so glad that we could make this day special for so many of you. So thanks a lot.
Favorite love song?
Lover by Taylor Swift.
Die for You by The Weeknd.
My Kind of Woman from Mac DeMarco.
I would trust my partner to go through my phone, but I feel like if they ask for it a lot, then that's kind of toxic, and that's a red flag. So no.
I would trust my partner to go through my phone because I have nothing to hide.
I would, because my phone is clean.
I would let my partner go through my phone.
What's your favorite romantic movie?
La La Land. It's fire.
Favorite romantic movie is The Notebook.
All the Bright Places.
We're gonna go to the arcade, bowling, and then we're gonna get food after.
I'm gonna eat the whole buffet, and I'm gonna go to New York after.
I'm going to dinner with my boyfriend.
Valentine's Day is my grandparents' anniversary, so we go to have dinner with the family.
I'm spending my Valentine's Day with my boyfriend. We're going to the movies, and then we're going to go have a nice dinner at La Petite in Baldwin Park.
For Valentine's Day, I will be going to dinner at Din Tai Fung. Yeah, I'll be going there.
Around, like, when you guys are both ready, of course, and, like, give it, like, maximum or minimum like 5 months, somewhere around there.
Everything's all right, you know, it's official and everything. That's why I say I love
it. And when it's the right time.
Right time too.
When you feel
perfect
it.
Time. Perfect time, yes sir.
When you feel it.
A day that promotes sadness for the people who have no one in their lives. So I think it should just be wiped out of the calendar. Boo to Valentine's Day.
I don't like that I see all the couples in the hallway.
So, you know, Avid has been, you know, very kind lately. They've been helping our school as a whole. And with everything going on, they've been having these special events throughout the whole school year. What are your thoughts on this?
I think it's good for what they're doing. From what I know is that they're doing some activities with the Cornerstone kids and with our counselors. And I think we should check it out. Let's go.
For Counselor Appreciation Week, the Avid program celebrated our counseling staff. Avid seniors created colorful posters and Avid sophomores hosted a special breakfast to honor our amazing counselors and to say thank you for all of their hard work.
Today what we're doing here is my Avid 10 students,
are about to begin their project or a unit in that's part of our AVID curriculum on community service. And so I just thought with Valentine's Day a few days away that it would be a good idea for them to come and interact and spend some time with our special needs population students.
You know what, I am so excited that the AVID, you know, took out the time to come work with my students. They're having a good time, they're communicating with the kids, talking, finding out their names, what their interests are, and then with the activities and the coloring, it's super nice.
So Jose, what do you think about the LBA?
I really think it's an interesting thing of what students have done, you know, to like gather around and play some basketball, and especially that it's like a little mock of the NBA, you know, like it's kind of cool that they could do that. It's like their own little type of fantasy basketball. And I think our Sierra Vision crew managed to go out and get some clips, so let's travel right into it.
This group was formed to organize teams for everybody to play in, for me and my friends, and anyone who is interested in joining. Yes, I plan to continue this activity. I'm planning to see who could take commissioner and continue this legacy. I know the school will help us out. I appreciate the school.
So the biggest game happened in February, which was the Super Bowl. It was against the Los Angeles Rams versus the Cincinnati Bengals. It was a crazy game in my opinion. It was really good, you know. What are your thoughts on it, Jose?
I had the same thoughts as you, Mauricio. You know, like, crazy game and all that. It was a good game. And that the Rams deserved it a lot. You know, LA needed a win after a couple of years. And we were able to interview some people around campus on, like, who they thought was going to win the Super Bowl. And I think we should touch down on these clips.
Super Bowl.
I think the Rams are
going
to take it.
Come on, Bengals. You already know that.
I want the Rams to win.
So
I want
real.
The Bengals to win.
The Bengals. Joe Burrow.
I think the Rams are going to win.
I think it'll be a good game, but the Rams are just better.
But I know who's going to win. So the Rams are going to win, undoubtedly, because they just, it's time. It's our time. It's Allie's time to blow the Bengals out. So everyone needs to put their horns up and go Rams, because we're going to take this on Sunday.
Rams are going to win the Super Bowl because we're winners.
My prediction will be for the Rams.
I think the Rams are going to win. It's time for Los Angeles to have a Super Bowl win. Stafford is an excellent quarterback, and I think the Super Bowl gods are on the Rams' side. Sorry, Bengals.
The Rams, because they have Aaron Donald.
They forced me to say the Bengals, so the Bengals.
Oh, the Rams are definitely going to win because the defense, you know, is so much better.
Oh, the Bengals.
The Bengals, Joe Shiesty.
I got Bengals winning the Super Bowl 34-31. I think it's going to be a close game.
I got the Bengals winning.
All right, and then you want to say why?
Because I hate the Rams. So...
So the winter rally happened. What'd you think of it?
It was actually a really good winter rally. You know, ASB did a really good job on it. Also, they had a special theme throughout the whole week. It was Harry Potter, and they had these, you know, special everyday things to do. And it was really good, in my opinion. What about you? What are your thoughts on it?
I really enjoyed the Spirit Week along with the rally. And I think our crew was able to cover it. So I think we should roll the clips. So February is Black History Month, you know. It's an annual celebration we do every year to look back at the history of what African Americans have accomplished in the U.S.
Yeah, it's actually a really nice month that recognizes all the African Americans that have changed this world or changed this country as a whole. And, you know, they influence a lot of people during our generation. And I feel like it's really important, especially now with everything going on. And I feel like we should learn more about that.
February is Black History Month, a time to honor and celebrate African Americans and Black Americans.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
That America is a place where all things are possible. Who still wonders if the dream of our founders is alive in our time. Who still questions the power of our democracy. Tonight is your answer.
We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal.
So, you and me can agree on one thing, and that's the year's been very chaotic.
Yeah, I get you with that. Like, the year has been very chaotic, especially when, you know, we were in quarantine for a while, for, you know, almost the whole school year last year. And coming back has been refreshing because, you know, we're able to interact with people, be with friends, be in clubs, and, you know, participate in sports, which has been really nice, you know?
Yeah, and I'm kind of glad that we had our yearbook crew, you know, like, being able to gather up those memories, and I think we should take a look at what they have for us.
There you have it. McDonald's.
Are you interested in buying a yearbook?
Yes.
Did you say yes?
Aww. Yay!
Well, this year's 2021-2022 yearbook is bigger than ever. Come with me to talk to our yearbook advisor, Mr. Garcia, to find out more details and see why this yearbook is so special. Follow me. Hi, Mr. Garcia. The students want to know what makes this yearbook so special.
Did you guys know that we've added 70 pages to the yearbook this year? That means it's going to be nearly 40% bigger than all of the yearbooks in the previous years. Joanna, that means more memories, more pictures, and more stories that you guys want to hear. It's going to be very exciting. Plus, we're super excited to announce that there will be a signing party, assuming that COVID allows it, at the end of the year, so that all of your friends can come and sign your yearbook.
So Sadie's is coming up on March 11th. Are you gonna be going?
I mean, I don't know. It just depends if a special someone you know, invites me. What about you though?
You should have not asked me that question because we already know the answer to that. But from what I know is that our crew made a commercial, so I think we should go downtown and roll the commercial. So this month had plenty of events, we can agree.
Yep.
And so Dons, we want to thank you all for watching, and we will see you guys in the next episode. Bye.
Peace out.